Hello, Confetti Club. It is Pixie, and today is a Designer Diaries because it is related to moving out. I have my first sensible home goods moving out adult stuff haul. Now, I do have some other things that I'm not going to show in this video because they're heavy and in the garage, such as a toaster that I got for my birthday. Thank you, Mom. I'm so excited to toast a bagel. I got cutlery. I got another pan, but I have another pan here to show you. I have two pans. I can make eggs and bacon. But the exciting thing about this video that I'm like so stoked about is that everything here, at least in my opinion, is cute as hell. I was just in New York and we walked by a store called Flying Tiger, which I believe is Danish, and it's kind of like IKEA but smaller and way cuter. Like oh my god, the vlog will come out. I lost my mind. It was so fun. We didn't even know it was there. I'd vaguely heard of it before. Went in. Oh my god, I only spent like $55 and I got so many things that I can use in my kitchen and in my house, and everything's cute. So it is time for a pastel yet practical home goods haul. Oh, I also have a couple other things from other places. Maybe I will start with those and then get into the big ol' Flying Tiger haul. So I picked this up from Michael's. This is a tin. It was in like the little door bit right when you go in, and it was with some other like gardening planting things. So I think this is supposed to be some sort of vase. What does it say? French bucket. Oui, oui, merci. But I thought this would be wicked for keeping cat toys, like the long, my cat's here and she's freaking out. The long ones on the sticks, and you guys know I am taking Serena with me. Hi. Hi. Ah, you are so sweet. Oh, wow, I love her so much. Okay, so anyway, yeah, these also come in lavender and a pastel green. But anyway, yes, I just thought this would be sick for holding cat toys. And it really is. And then you can put like little mousies and little balls and stuff. She loves these. She loves these so much. They're like 50 cents and she goes insane. This is her favorite mousie. Hi, do you want your favorite mouse? Yes, bucket from Michael's for cat toys. Pink, very good, good. Ooh, actually, I also got another thing from that section. Let me run and grab it. Okay, this I probably didn't need as much, but I love my herbs, and I'm hoping that in the apartment or townhouse or whatever that I get, I will have some sort of balcony, some sort of outside area of some sort in which I can have flowers. If not, I will have a little indoor kitchen herb garden, but this is definitely humongous. But I couldn't resist because it's green gingham. Again, they also had it in pink and lavender, I believe. Also from Michael's. It's a watering can. It's too cute. I love it. Yes, go Michael's. Thank you. This, I haven't even opened this up yet. This I got from Pick2 in Rockefeller Center. And I was so excited. Dude, there are some cute measuring cups out there. But when I saw these, I knew these were the measuring cups for me. They are called measuring ducks. And they are, hopefully I got the right one, pastel. Yeah, I did. Ah! Little amazing pastel measuring cups that look like ducks. Hopefully the measurements are accurate, but like I'm not Gordon Ramsay. I'm not cooking with Bobbish. Like, we'll be fine. Oh my god, let me give you a close-up. Oh yes, roll that beautiful duck footage. Little fourth of a cup. Very beautiful, thank you. Third of a cup. Oh my god. Half a cup. Beautiful yellow boy. And of course, one cup is our pink boy. And then they stack ever so beautifully as the happy- Oh wait, actually you can stack their little heads. They have a little thing so you can put their little heads so they're happy little ducks! Oh, that's cute. I don't know if I like that or like that more. That's like they're all on like a field trip and they're looking out the window. Yes, measuring ducks. Thank you, Pick2. This is adorbs. I have a bunch of other stuff from Pick2 that will be in my main non-home goods related haul, but These are my sweet ducks. I have a couple of mugs. Don't know if this counts, but this one is a freaking flamingo with a freaking neck. And I got this at, what was it called? Burlington, I think, which was very much like what we have here, which is called Winners or HomeSense. Is it the same company? I Googled it and it seemed like they weren't. But anyway, I got this and I love him a lot. This one is from Bed Bath & Beyond. I might not even need glasses. I might just freaking drink all my like juice and like everything, make a little cocktail in a mug. Cause I just have, I've accumulated so many mugs, but this one's from Bed Bath & Beyond and it's really cute. Speaking of cocktails and alcohol, I also did get this shot glass from Dylan's Candy Bar. I keep calling it David's Candy Bar and it's very problematic. I had no time to actually shop there when I had my event. So this is from the Dylan's Candy Bar in the Toronto airport. But he's cute. It says Dylan's Candy Bar, New York. Oh, which is weird because I got it in Toronto. And then it says candy is dandy, but liquor is quicker. And I thought it was cute. I've been looking for a cute little shot glass for a while. It helps to measure. If you're making a little mixed drink, it's good to actually measure to make sure you're not like gonna ruin your insides or like get nothing. So measuring. I bought this also at Burlington. Was this a dumb thing to purchase and bring back in my suitcase? I mean, I had to get a second suitcase because I wasn't expecting all of the wonderful, generous freaking prezzies that I got at my meetup. But I was worried that this was gonna like be too heavy and make my bag oversized, but it wasn't. Oh my God, it's the prettiest little frying pan you've ever gosh darn seen. This was $9.99. It's not that heavy. I mean like it's frying pan weight. And then the inside is non-stick, dude. Nothing is sticking today. Oh my God. She's sharper image, 12-inch, non-stick, aluminium frying pan, soft grip handle, and it's baby blue. Dude, oh my God, I'm gonna have the cutest kitchen of all time. I'm freaking out. So yeah, this is a frying pan. I also got a red frying pan for my birthday, so like I said, I am ready to fry, or perhaps one can be a self-defense weapon. Can you see my cat? She does this thing where when she scratches, she like sticks her tongue out and we don't know why. I also got, I don't know if this counts as homewares. It probably doesn't, but I'm showing you them anyway. My cat is playing with the cat toys in the thing. I love you, baby girl. What are you doing? Oh. It's Easter, and this Easter season, we have been blessed with so much Peeps memorabilia in like very accessible stores. These are from my dollar store. I got all of them. I like this one the most, but the side of this one is very bougie. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna keep something in them. We got some Peeps lunch boxes. That's the end of the lunchbox segment. That is everything that is not from Flying Tiger. So it is time to get into the big boy Flying Tiger haul. What toy do you want, sweetie? I'll get it for you. It's okay. Probably the thing that I'm most excited about. Maybe that's not true. I got a colander. I'm very hype about it. My cat's being silly. It is a pastel pink kind of lavender colander. My dude, oh my God. I have like a beautiful fantasy in my head that once a week or once a month, probably once a month, I want my friends to come over. I want to cook for them. I want to cook together so that like even though we're all living away from our family, we can have like a happy little home-cooked meal, and I want to make some goddamn lasagna. And now I can in style with my beautiful pastel pink colander. Beep! My one and only son. My pink colander. This might be kind of rapid fire because there's not too much to say about this, but we got, oh my God, is it a heart? No. Okay. I almost had a freak out, but this is a lavender dustpan and little sweepy thing. No crumbs on my floor, dude. No crumbs on the bottom of your freaking naked feet, dude. We're gonna be clean as hell. Nice. Good. Thanks. Again, for my tiny herb garden, I got tiny gardening tools. These are so cute and also genuinely the perfect size for like a little baby herb garden. They're just so cute. And also, again, the pink, the lightwood, the aesthetic,
delicioso. Thank you.
Again, with the kitchen theme, this perfectly matches the dustpan, but this is a little scrubby brush for doing your dishes. Oh my gosh, I can wash my pastel sky blue frying pan with my pastel lavender brush. We love doing the dishes in this house. Also, I'm sorry, it's just too cute. This is a sink strainer. I'm freaking out. They also had a sink plunger, but my mom was like, if you have a sink strainer and you use it, you shouldn't need a sink plunger. The sink plunger was cute though. But we got some sink strainers, pink and purple. Gorgeous, lovely, very nice. Oh, I forgot about these. Oh my gosh. I got some Tupperware type stuff for putting leftovers in and that sort of thing. But they're pink. They also had them in blue, but it was a bit more of like a dusty muted blue. And this is my favorite kind because it's so much easier to put on than like some of those Tupperware where you have to kind of like shove it on and it's like impossible and then you get pasta sauce all over you. No, none of that today. You put your little leftovies in there, you give them a little thing. I got two of them and they do indeed stack. Look at that. Stick them in the frickin' Lazy Susan. You're good to go, dude. I'm so happy. These are tablecloth weights, which I didn't know was a thing, but they were so cheap and they are so cute. And I do intend on having a tablecloth if I have a kitchen table. I might not because I'll be living alone. But I have a very, very cute pastel rainbow gingham tablecloth. And I thought these would be just perfect for him. Oh, I got this. This is a soap dispenser. I also have a really cute strawberry soap dispenser that I intend to use in my actual bathroom, but I thought this would be wicked to put dish soap in because the dish soap that we use here at least is like you can buy in a bag to get refills. So yeah, he's cute. Again, it matches the little freaking dish scrubby brush. So together, we're gonna be so clean. Also, they wrap your stuff in the cutest little like candy tissue paper. This was just to protect the glass. This wasn't gift wrapping or anything. And I got this really adorable sugar container because I do enjoy some tea and it's just the cutest and it's pink and I got it. That was all that was like super strictly like home goods, but I did get two other things from Flying Tiger that I want to show you. This is all cute and I freaked out. My mom showed it to me and oh my god, you'll see it in the vlog. I freaked out. This is a teeny tiny shopping cart. I love tiny things. First of all, the wheels actually move. Second of all, I'm freaking out. Third of all, the little seat thing does move, and if you got multiples, you could do the old, you can actually like stack them together like a real freaking cart corral. Do I need this? No, but I could put soap in it, or perhaps other things. I don't know, perhaps a peep. I have many of those right now. You wait for the haul, there's several peeps. Look at him going for a ride. I love this. I freaked out. In the picture here, they have it with pens. I don't know. This is whatever you want to make of it. I love it. I'm so happy. And also, this is a silly little thing. You know I am the B-Day queen. You know I love birthday aesthetics all year round, not just when it's my birthday, because it's always somebody's birthday. And I just thought these were way too adorable. They kind of remind me of my YouTube intro with the gummies. I thought these would be cute hanging somewhere. Very aesthetic, very cute, very soft. Very nice. This video's featured confetti club members are babybunny.jpg and evening.surprise on Instagram, both who drew some very lovely, super adorbs, wonderful, spectacular, never been seen before images. That was supposed to be a reference to the Lady Gaga gif, but it didn't really work. Of me looking cute, extra cute in this artwork from Evening Surprise. We have a remake of my hot pic that I took literally in front of a Michaels like forever ago and photoshopped the bricks rainbow. This is so cute. I love your interpretation of the bricks with the cute little rectangies in the background. Very beautiful, wonderful, cute, sparkly. I wish I was that sparkly IRL. And from babybunny.jpg, we have a really, really cute picture in a super cool style. I love this. I love my hair like that. My hair's never been like that, but I wish it was because it looks really cool. Clow wand and a freaking Sakura freaking card, and it's cool as hell. And I love you two very much, and I thank you for your support and love. I love you guys so, so much, and I'll see you in the next video, which is not this one, because this one is over. Bye!